Hi, today I'm going to show you a run-through on BSD Online. This is the login page. Students can log in with either the Google SSO or Microsoft. We also do have third-party API integration. Of course, students can log in with their email address and username. And students also have the opportunity to be issued a login code or a classroom code by their teacher, which can take them seamlessly into the application interface. I'm going to log in with the Google SSO. This is the landing interface for a teacher. Here you can see your classrooms, and these are classrooms that you're either teaching or that you're enrolled in. If I was a student, I would only see what I was enrolled in. If I'm a teacher and I'm doing PD, I'd be enrolled in a classroom, but mainly I would be teaching classrooms. I can also see my library, and I can see all the different courses that are available to me in the beginner, intermediate, or advanced. Within each of these courses, I can look and I can see the full resources and projects that are within the course. Here you can see the course description. I can see a course progression which includes the pacing step by step. I can overview of what would be learnt. Then I can look in and I can see there are slide documents, a project and a quiz, which is a standard BSD format. I can also see previews of projects that the students will create. As a teacher, I might have created sandboxes that my students will use. Or students, when they finished a project, they export them into sandboxes. And so then this is where they have free access to the code in order to edit it further and create really independent, creative and authentic projects that represent their real-world interests. You can see here that the projects that are highlighted and hearted appear in the portfolio as highlighted options. The portfolio itself can be shared by students externally as a link or a QR code. Many of our students do share that when they're applying for universities, the competitions, or when they're submitting work in school. As a teacher, I also have a tab where I can manage student information. I can add and remove students to my organization. Going back to the classroom, this is the primary interface for a teacher. I'm going to quickly create a new classroom here. So, one of the first things I'd do within the new classroom, I would name the classroom. You can see I'm a teacher. Here, I can add other teachers into this classroom, so I can have multiple teachers that could be for supply cover. There are advanced tools like databases available. Every concept that students learn or come across within BSD Online is available within the interactive glossary. One other thing, if I'm going to generate a code for students to log in, that would be here. You can see, very easy. I simply generate that classroom code, and the students can use that and come straight to the platform. Now, if I'm setting up my lesson, I'd first look to add content into the lesson. I'm going to move my cursor here and selected a beginner course. You can see, mirroring the library, that the resources are available. I can see different aspects of the course. And then what I can do is I can add the course to my classroom. I can edit aspect of the course. So if I wanted to take the planning document, you can see this is only teacher available. I can make it student available, and then I can choose to move it in the flow. If I also want to add other content into any of my lesson, I can also go in here. I can add an information step, a video step, a sandbox, one of my own quizzes, or any of my teaching resources. I can truly customize. There are also further projects available within BSD Online that can be added into the lesson or into the course flow to customize the student learning experience. When I have finished editing, I can click this button to lock the progression until I want to edit it further. Here, I can add more students in from the list. As I go in, I simply add a student there in my classroom, and then I can see them in their lesson. While I'm teaching my classroom as a teacher, at any time I've got access to the support chat. And I also have access to the in-classroom chat, where I can chat with different students for different lessons that I am teaching. Different classrooms. You can see here a classroom that has more students in it. I can see the live progress here, which is updated from a student. Of course, these are dummy students. But with this one, here you can see that Brent is doing AI chess player in step 2. This is what Brent has done. I have access to Brent's model answer. I can also check this one has been passed. This one shouldn't be empty. I can see in the class here. I can see the progress that the students have made. Within assessments, I am able to view the progress students have made. If I'm looking at it from a student view. This is the final view. And I can see everything that has been completed and learnt in the project. I'm just going to restart the project. This is a student view. Every project starts with a view of what the student is going to create. The student can have a look at the steps that they are going to go through in order to complete the project. I'm just going to click Next. At the beginning of this project, I can see I need to create a div, and I need to give that a class element if I don't know what a div is. Of course, if I'm in the lesson and I've got my teachers there, I can ask my teacher. But also, there is an interactive card that shows what a div is and how you use it. In this step of this project, if I'm a teacher, I'd have access to a model answer. I can add what I need. I can check my objective. It's passed. If there was a mistake, it would tell me what was there to fix in order to pass to the next step. That was a quick run-through on BSD Online. To learn more about BSD education, subscribe to our YouTube channel or click another video to keep watching.